if you are seeing the presentation or not. One second. Okay, now, okay. So, well, so the main goal of our demonstration is to show the two different CEPs. One is going to be CEM and is going to simulate the CEP that will be running at the vessels. These CEPs are going to run different rules. We have two kinds of rules. One are that are ones are the ones that detect unexpected values on the sensors, and this is prepared only for some sensors, not for all of them. Here we can see some of the rules that, for instance, the volume of the fuel consumption has to be between 0 and 300. And we have another kind of rules that are the ones that detect the values of two sensors at the same time. For instance, the power and the revolutions per minute. That has to be the power lower than 1000 and the revolutions per minute higher than 60. In that cases, an alarm is going to be prompted, and the is going to be
I
sent.
know, I
Yes.
know. Sorry for the interruption.
Yes.
Could I ask you to pinpoint what is new as compared with the interim review?
Okay.
Because this is important.
Okay. So what is different of the internal review is that, for instance, we are going to simulate six vessels instead of with the midterm review that we show only one vessel. And here we are going to have the part of the vessels running at GPM, and the part of the data center is going to be run Boston Test Bed. So we are going to have in total a total 798 events per second that we are going to receive at the Boston Test Bed. So, well, here is an example of the rules that we have. And well, what has been done is that we are able to simulate the connection between GPM and the Boston Test Bed, and we are able to store the data in case of connection losses. I didn't test it in the Boston Test Bed, but I tested with the UPM, so it should work. Regarding the CEP2, that is the one that is on test bed, we are able to receive data from UPM. We have input queues that are going to simulate that the system is not able to solve the load, so the data stops there and waits till the system is able to process. And this is going to be one of the indicators in order to scale up and scale down the queries. We have integrated with LeanScale. We are integrated partially with the Work Package 5 with the Grafana dashboard, because I have to integrate the last dashboard that I have generated. And regarding the integration with Work Package 3, we are integrated with the REST API, and I'm waiting to my in order to integrate everything with the data orient with the with his sorry, a component. And what has to be done is to performance an evaluation with more vessels and to modify the load and see what how the CEP is able to scale up and scale down with all the information that has the Work Package 3 components. So let me check if I can do some demonstration. Yeah, it does. So. Okay. So I have two different dashboards. This dashboard is integrated with the with the with Word Package, and the other one is not yet integrated, but I'm working on that. So I hope to have this today or tomorrow. What we can see here is the for in one part the amount of memory that is still able to be used in the for each of the components of the CEP. In the upper right hand, we can see the CPU usage of each of the components of the CEP. Down we can see the network, the amount of bytes that are being transmitted, received from the UPM and between the different instance managers. And here we can see the queue. So in the second chart, we can see from one part the rules that the sorry the data that came from UPM. So in the upper left hand, we can see a store sensor values graph. That what is doing here is that we are receiving some data with the values of the sensors and the alarms, and we can see with the yellow and orange the latency in order to store this data into linear scale. Here we are showing now that the load is increasing because I have started deploying more vessels, so we can see the effect that the increase. In the down part, we can see one of the rules that is to check if we are receiving null consecutive values from the sensors of the vessels, and in case of that, is going to be registered an alarm into LineScale. From another part, where we have to wait for the values because it is still running. So here in the upper left hand, what we are going to see are the alarms that checks the values of two sensors at the same time, and the time that takes to store to be stored in scale. And in the lower part, we are going to show the charter party agreements violation rule that. Well, I don't know exactly why it's not working now, but well, what is doing here is that the data from the sensors came, we are reading data from LineScale, we are comparing those values, and in case that there is a violation, it's going to be stored at LineScale. So this is the data that we can see from the Boston testbed. And here, so well, here should be, I don't know why, but here we should see the data that came from each of the vessels. So what is expected to see here is that the values of the cell from the different parts of the vessel. And in the left hand, we are going to see the values of this that came from the main engine particularly. So here we are going to see for each of the vessels the amount of data that is being processed and the amount of data that is going to be sent to the data center. So we are going to be able to see both parts, one from the vessel that this part is running at UPM, and the other dashboard that are running at the Boston testbed. So that's all from now. I'm still working on complete everything and to be able to present all of the parts because I have tested the scale up and the scale down, but it was doing sending messages to AI. not from the Mauricio's component. So we have to continue working and to integrate everything. But I think that we are in a good position. So that's all from my part.
Thanks a lot, Anoa. This is indeed very, very good, I think. You are almost near complete integration because a small part is missing with Anestis and hopefully also a small part with Maurizio.
Yes.
And then more or less you are done. I think it will be my impression is that when you will when you will present the final demo, it will be very important to only speak about the new parts.
Okay.
For instance, at the beginning, you spoke of the rules. It was not clear to me whether there was some new thing here or not. You also spoke afterward of two consecutive null values. I think that this was already spoke about and demonstrated in the interim review.
Yes.
So you can.
I will not, sorry to interrupt you, Joseph, they will not recall that. No way.
Well,
okay.
All the rules were presented at the midterm review. But I don't know, I think that it could be a good idea, maybe not to go very deep into the rules, but to give a general idea in order to continue the flow, because we
yeah.
suddenly presented
yeah,
the dashboard and everything. I think that the people is going to be like, that is not going to be very representative of the work and all the stuff.
Yeah, there is some chance that the reviewers will have a recap of what they saw in the interim review. And in any case, I think that globally we have a lot of things to demonstrate. So it's it will always better to put the emphasis on the new things. And you really have new things, especially. It will be interesting, very, very interesting to see the scaling
yeah.
demo. This is completely new, and also it is a new thing that we are integrating with Work Package 3.
Yeah.
So I think you have a lot to speak about. So
yes. Yes, because
okay.
I have to explain very well the scale up and the scale down, so it's going to take time. And
yeah.
as you, it's the most important part here. So yes.
Yeah. So the plan is we discussed that a few months ago in a Danaus meeting, and also Demos were there. So the plan is that after Ainoa and Marta show their part with the scale up and scale down. Then we move to lean scale, where Pavlos will in fact also demonstrate scale up, scale down, but this time. This is for a completely different component. Instead of being a lightweight CEP component, this will be, I could say, a heavyweight database of lean scale. And the point is that we have no chance at all to, we don't even try to do it at Boston because of resources and many technical limitations that we have there. So the idea is that that Pavlos will say in the same way that CEP, which has just been shown, is integrating with Work Package 3, etc., etc. So lean scale database has the same integration, and then Pavlos will show. A demo, but which will not be at Boston. A demo which will be standalone, of this very important demo, because this is a full task of lean scale, the ability to scale up and scale down, and not only to scale, but also to show that the performance stays quiet and affected, which is quite of a feat, I would say. So so this is a full demo part, but which is not integrated at Boston. We I understand from Demos that we will not emphasize that this is not integrated. But
this neither that nor you know where it is deployed, etc. I mean, you know, whether it is at Boston or whether it is integrated or whatever, you know, we it's obsolete.
Okay. So I don't know. So let's have now Pavlos, who will explain us what is the status of this demo part. And in between demos, can you call George? I think that George is not here. Yeah, can you call George and ask him if he plans to join us? Because
I did. Most probably, he will be able to join, but maybe it's gonna be, you know, too late for us.
Okay. So what we can do, I know it is not optimal, but what we can do is that we will skip George's part. And then we will have it later, so even in the middle of the next scenario. But that's what we can do.
Or at the end, I think either at the end or, you know, not at all, so we don't break the flow. But